Hey guys, this is Vincent, and in this video I'm going to do a quick review of Topaz Video Enhance AI. In front of me I have a video that I recorded on my iPhone 6s in Peru. It's a 1080p video and it's about 14 seconds long. So I'm just going to close this clip here, and I'm going to drag the video file into Video Enhance AI, and we'll take a look at the right side, which helps you select the AI processing model or the settings for you to upscale or enlarge your video. So the first option we have is the video quality, and Video Enhance AI, it recommends or suggests the settings. So it's recommending a low quality, but there's also a medium and high, and they also provide a tooltip or a toolbox or a tooltip box for giving you information on each of these settings. But I'll just leave it on low. The video type is progressive. If you have old VHS videos that's digitized, it's probably going to be interlaced, and then there's also CG or computer generated video type spot. We'll just leave it on progressive since it's 1080p. The artifact type, it's a codec file, H.264 compressed, so I'll just leave it on that. And then we come here to the recommended processing models, or the AI or the machine learning technology Topaz Labs uses to upscale your video. So it's recommending two right now, the Artemis Low Quality or the Artemis Strong D-Halo. We can compare these processing models. Like right now we have the original without any processing model upscaled, and here's the Artemis Low Quality, and then the Artemis Strong D-Halo, and this one there's no fourth or third processing model that was offered, so it says no model selected. It does sometimes offer or suggest three or four models, and you can't really notice too much of a difference between these models on this preview here, just because the video is 1080p, so it's decent quality compared to like interlaced video. But anyways, I'll go back to a single view, and if you want to see all the processing models, you can just click on all, and they're right here. They're grouped into four main sections: Artemis, Dione, or Gaia, and Theia. And they're named after Greek mythology or Greek gods, and I'm probably butchering their names, but it is what it is. I'll just go back to suggested, and I will leave the sizing on 200, which is same thing as 4K when it's being upscaled from 1080p, and we'll just leave it on crop to fill frame. The grain settings, I'll leave it on. It's common when you're upscaling or enlarging an image or a video, and there's noise reduction or denoising involved. Video format for the output file, I'll just leave it on H.264. Keep the audio off. I don't need audio for the output file when I show you guys the comparison later on. I'll leave the compression factor at 20. And one thing about Video Enhance AI, it is GPU or CPU intensive, depending on if you don't have a GPU, but I don't recommend it without a GPU, otherwise it'll just take too long to render. Even buffering through this, it takes a little bit of time. And if you do want to see a higher quality preview, you can just click here, click on preview, it'll render 30 seconds. So I'm going to do that right now. It does take about a minute to render the preview, and while it's rendering, when Video Enhance AI first came out back in March 2020, the only GPU that was supported was Nvidia on Windows, but now it also supports AMD on Windows as well as AMD on Mac, or only AMD on Mac. When it originally did come out, Mac AMD was not supported. In addition, the Gaia upscaling or processing model is not supported either for AMD, so you need to select one of the other processing models. So hopefully it takes a few more seconds for this video to render and show us the 30 seconds or the sorry the 30 preview frames, and it should be any minute now. Okay, here we go. So here's the preview, which is Artemis low quality. I'll go to view and click side by side, and right away I can see it's much more detailed or much more sharp. On the right side is the Video Enhance AI upscale, and this is without the any processing models. So let me just click on pause here, and you can see on the edges of the horse or the donkey, as well as the man riding it, it's much more sharp on the Video Enhance AI processing model. Even the road is more sharp, and I can notice in all the contrast areas it's more sharp. This on this uncompleted or incomplete building is also sharp, as well as these vegetation here. But anyways, I'll close this and I'm going to start processing it, and I'll show you guys the final output, as well as some other footage that I upscaled using my GoPro 3 Black from 1080p to 4K on a, and I'll show that to you as well. And that video was, those videos were recorded on from the Galapagos Islands. It does take some time though for these videos to render, so this will probably change. It says 10 minutes, it'll keep going up, but it might take like 20 or 30 minutes. And you can also do a batch processing if you want, like you can just drag a whole bunch of video files down here before you start processing it, and then you can upscale them all at once. Alright, so if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'm going to show you the upscaled comparisons in a few seconds. Have a good one.